This video is optional, but we wanted to answer the question, are there uncomputable functions? Yes, there are well-defined discrete functions that cannot be computed by any Turing machine. In other words, no algorithm that can compute f of x for arbitrary finite x in a finite number of steps. It's not that we don't know the algorithm, we can actually prove that no algorithm exists. So the finite memory limitations of FSMs wasn't the only barrier as to whether we can solve a problem. The most famous uncomputable function is the so-called halting function. When Turing machines undertake a computation, there are two possible outcomes. Either the Turing machine writes an answer onto the tape and halts, or the Turing machine loops forever. The halting function tells us which outcome we'll get. Given two integer arguments, k and j, the halting function determines if the kth Turing machine halts when given a tape containing j as the input. Let's quick sketch an argument as to why the halting function is not computable. Well, suppose it was computable, then it would be equivalent to some Turing machine, say T sub h. So we can use T sub h to build another Turing machine, T sub n. The n stands for nasty, that processes its single argument and either loops or halts. T sub n of x is designed to loop if Turing machine x, given input x, halts. And vice versa, T sub n of x halts if Turing machine x, given input x, loops. The idea is that T sub n of x does the opposite of whatever T sub x of x does. T sub n is easy to implement, assuming that we have T sub h to answer the halts or loops question. Now, consider what happens if we give n as the argument to T sub n. From the definition of T sub n with the argument of n will loop if the halting function tells us that T sub n with the argument of n halts. And T sub n with the argument of n will halt if the halting function tells us that T sub n with the argument n loops. Obviously, T sub n of n can't both loop and halt at the same time. So, if the halting function is computable and T sub h exists, we arrive at this impossible behavior for T sub n applied to the argument n. This tells us that T sub h cannot exist, and hence that the halting function is not computable.